All right, ugly, ugly topic. This is going to be the right to life. And when I say right to life, I mean when you're really old or, you know, you're dying of something, you want to be put out of your misery. And usually when I, you know, end stages of all kinds of things going on, you know, we have obviously a medical system that has been giving and giving and giving and giving, and how much can it crank out some more? You know, it's just, you know, give you pretty much everything. It just starts to be plug and play body. And do we have like a whole total brain input yet? No, they haven't done that. No, that one is not working. No. They have very expensive machinery and equipment, but no, it does not work, to my knowledge. Putting people out of their misery. Now, when we are talking about 20 new infants, children into the world, we need 20 older people to vacate. So it keeps that at least the balance now, and we can just keep this like, you know, we can keep that balance and figure out what are we gonna do, because we already have so many problems. Now we can't increase. we've got to keep our where we're at. So how are we going to maintain 20 to 20? I mean, the obvious is for the doctors to be less pushy, and we're blaming the doctors. Well, the doctors are taught to just keep sewing and cutting and sewing and cutting, aren't they? They're just taught to be that. So they're going to keep going as far as the money is there. And the money is coming from the insurance companies. So because the money is coming from the insurance companies, it's an endless supply, isn't it? So everybody's running out and getting their insurance, running out and getting this extra insurance. This is not the new government I'm talking about. This is the old one. They're running out and getting that extra insurance all these years. It's piled up higher and higher and higher. The conglomerates are like, yes, you can keep operating, you can keep going, you can get really expensive machines, you can definitely. Why not stay in that hospital room as long as possible? This has been going on because of the insurance, the push for everybody to get this insurance at a very young age, even. So we're all culpable in a weird, odd way that we have this massive population, because we've all gotten these jitters. Do I need insurance? You know, the jitters. It's going to cost so much if I ever go in there, isn't it? So we have to pay monthly out or something. Some of us don't pay because we don't have the money, but others have been paying, haven't they? They've been paying. And and so the old keep getting operated on, and in some cases it's just completely cruel. It's become cruel. It's like, enough. We cannot have these operations going on any longer just because it's available, just because we have the machines, just because we have the know-how that, oh yeah, we can repair this right now, and then next week or next 3 weeks or next 4 months from now, we can repair that. You know, just because we have this insurance rise, a tantrum, that, you know, my goodness, it's expensive. It's expensive. You're sold it, aren't you? It's very expensive. And so you are creating higher lifetime lived numbers. Now, the lifetime lived numbers are not great. Not great under those conditions, because they're the conditions of constant operations and constant medications. So we have to stop that. That's been the pile on of how come the old people are still living way, way, way past. Yeah. So the insurance fear of propaganda has accelerated the life ages. And the life ages are not dying out. These older life ages are not dying out. And we have many, many, many young moving in, and so it's like, well, popular, popular, popular. We can't have that. Yeah, we need people to just die as normal. Without all of this constant little trip to the, oh my gosh, something hurt, something ached, something twinged. Why are people so namby-pamby for it? You know, I start to think, well, maybe they're going because they don't feel loved at home. Yeah, most plausibly, yeah. The big L word doesn't ring any bells. You get care and attention. Hopefully. And if you don't, you get something to complain over. It almost becomes, well, television's become boring. Let's just go to the hospital. Big serious topic for you, isn't it? Yeah. Well, so instead of treating and caring, gosh dang, I'm really crooked here. You'd think I had robbed a bank. offering medications on the out, and I go with opiates, natural opiates, any opium derivative. Is a demand request given from knowledge of being there already with the dying person. So when I'm saying opiates, I mean opium. So we need the opium to give to the old people so they can die out at home peacefully and not in the hospitals. And what else? What else do I have? I don't know. The marijuana thing on the way out? I don't know. I'm kind of sick of it. I think by that time they need straight up opiates.